Hello everyone, my name is Joseph and I'm part of the Identity Experience Cloud Engineering team at Microsoft. As an admin, you may have encountered problems due to lack of write permissions when exporting objects properties from Azure Active Directory to Active Directory using AAD Connect. In this video, I will explain how to fix the permissions issues provoked by inheritance problems in Active Directory. What is inheritance? Active Directory Domain Services supports inheritance of permissions down the object tree to allow the administration tasks to be performed at a higher level in the tree. This enables administrators to set up inheritable permissions on objects near the root, such as domain and organizational units, and have those permissions distributed to various objects in the tree. Inheritance is enabled by default, but can be changed according to your administrator or security requirements. Now, let's jump to the AAD Connect server to show the error. As you can see in the export step of the local connector, AAD Connect is displaying the error permissions issue. When we click on the error, we are seeing a description of the error which points to the lack of permissions from the local connector service account to write the value in the on-premises Active Directory. While clicking in the object, if you look in the change column, it will let us know which is the attribute that is trying to be added or modified. We will require this information to troubleshoot the issue later on. Now, let's have a look on how to fix the issue. In this scenario, the local connector service account doesn't have permissions to add the values to these two attributes in the Active Directory. Let's confirm the name of the local connector service account by going to the local connector properties. Let's click on Connect to Active Directory first. This is the username of my account. Now that we have the name of the account, let's jump to Active Directory users and computers. The easiest way to find a permissions inheritance issue is by starting troubleshooting from the single object level and start looking up where the inheritance is disabled. In this case, you can find the affected user by accessing the organizational unit or using the user and group finding tool. Once you find the user, right-click on the user and access the properties. Now, click on the Security tab and click Advanced. You can see that the inheritance is enabled for this user. We can confirm it since the configuration is asking if you want to disable it. Now that we know that the inheritance is enabled for the user, let's start looking up in the tree in which organizational unit the inheritance can be disabled. Right-click on the organizational unit, Security tab and Advanced. You can see that here the configuration asks if you want to enable it, meaning this organizational unit is not inheriting the permissions from its parent organizational unit, and therefore not applying the AAD Connect local connector account permissions to the objects under it. Now that we found the organizational unit blocking the inheritance, let's enable it and trigger a synchronization in the AAD Connect. As we can see, the permission issue error is not appearing anymore, meaning that the AAD Connect was able to export successfully the attributes to the Active Directory. Let's look for two more scenarios that can help you to troubleshoot inheritance issues. What happens if we assign a permission or enable inheritance, but AAD Connect is still showing the error? If you have multiple domain controllers, this could be due to a delay in the Active Directory replication. You can confirm this by making the changes in the Active Directory domain controller from which the AAD Connect is importing data. To check which domain controller it is, you can go to the synchronization service, connectors, right-click on the local connector, and go to properties. In configure directory partitions, you can configure to consume from a specific domain controller. Or also, you can see the last used domain controller from which the AAD Connect imported data. Now that you know which is the preferred domain controller, you can make the changes directly over the domain controller, and changes will be reflected immediately. Is there a way to confirm if organizational units or objects has the permission before enabling inheritance? The answer is yes. Let's check my AAD Connect local connector account permissions over this user. Right-click on the user, go to Security tab, and then Advanced. Click on Effective Access tab, select the AAD Connect local connector account, and then click on View Effective Access. Now, you can check all the attributes and permissions the AAD Connect service account has or not over the user. This same process applies if you want to check permissions over organizational units or at the domain level. Troubleshooting tips. If the error is happening for multiple users, identify if the users belong to the same organizational unit, and then start checking the inheritance from the organizational unit. If you want to assign permissions to write back a value just for specific users in the organizational unit, you can assign the permissions directly over the object level without enabling inheritance over the organizational unit. This is how we can analyze, troubleshoot, and fix an inheritance permissions issue on AAD Connect. Hopefully, you will find this video helpful. For more information, please refer to our public documentation at learn.microsoft.com. Thank you for your time, and see you next time.